Welcome to Learnpedia, the ultimate JEE and NEET prep tool that is currently being used by over 20,000 students. Take a look at this actual NEET question and see if you can answer that. If you think you got the answer, then post it in the comment section below. To understand the concept behind this question, go ahead and watch this video.
Mechanism of breathing. So first of all, we'll try to understand the basic breathing mechanism in human. Human shows negative pressure breathing. It means human lungs acts as suction pump to pull air. Please note this word, to pull air. Air get pulled towards lungs. We are not pushing air towards lungs. If we are pushing air towards lungs, that would be the positive pressure breathing. If lungs are able to pull the air, it would be negative pressure breathing. Let us understand this concept. For example, there are two balloons which are interconnected. If we want to push air from balloon A to B, then there are two ways. Number one,
to send air from A to B.
Number one is contraction of balloon A. Number two, expansion of B. If B expands, it means volume of B get increased, which results in decrease in pressure. Simply we can say negativity get created in balloon B. So this negative pressure will pull air from A to B. So whenever lungs expand, the expansion of lungs increases volume and decreases pressure,
which helps to suck
air from out to in. This one means negative pressure breathing. Now discuss this topic in more detail. Let us now discuss respiratory muscle. Respiratory muscles are intercostal muscles, phrenic muscle, and we can also take abdominal muscle. Intercostal muscle are further of two types: internal intercostal muscles and external intercostal muscles. Let us now discuss
something about these muscles.
Well, the word was intercostal muscles. Now try to understand the word costa or costal
is for rib.
Inter means between.
So these are the muscles which are present between ribs.
See, let us suppose this is one rib, this is second rib, these are the muscles between rib, so I can call them intercostal. If these muscles are present on outer side of rib, then such muscles are called external intercostal muscles. If these are present on inner side, then such muscles are called internal intercostal muscles. The second muscle was phrenic muscle. Phrenic muscles are muscles of diaphragm. If we make a rough diagram of rib cage, by front side, it will be shown in this way. Say this is sternum, these are ribs, and this is diaphragm. You can see diaphragm is curved, and when this diaphragm moves down, by the contraction of phrenic muscle, volume of rib cage get increased,
which will help in inhalation.
Third muscle is abdominal muscle. Abdominal muscle usually helps during forceful exhalation. So right now we have discussed intercostal muscles, means between ribs, which are of two types: external intercostal muscle and internal intercostal muscle. Apart from that, next muscle was phrenic, which is the muscle of diaphragm, and one more abdominal muscle. So all these muscles collectively
help in normal inhalation,
normal exhalation, forceful exhalation,
these aspects one by one.
So now discuss inspiration.
Inspiration simply means inhalation of air
brought by number one, external intercostal muscle, number two, phrenic muscle. Contraction of external intercostal muscle will pull rib cage forward, upward at dorsoventral axis, and contraction of phrenic muscle will move diaphragm downward to anteroposterior axis. Well, contraction of external intercostal will pull ribcage forward, upward at dorsoventral axis means going to increase the volume of ribcage and going to decrease the pressure of ribcage. Similarly, contraction of phrenic muscles of diaphragm move downward at anteroposterior axis is also going to increase the volume of ribcage.
Means going to decrease the pressure in ribcage.
Now you can see in this diagram, if this structure is rib, you can see here, this is also rib. Between these ribs, muscles are mentioned, this and this. You can see it from the diagram. This is on the outer surface, so I can call it external intercostal muscle, and this one internal intercostal muscle. As I have discussed, when these muscles contract, they will pull ribcage outward. Outward means forward and upward, and outward to dorsoventral axis. Let us now discuss again external intercostal muscles, which I have already mentioned.
Present
at outer side of ribcage. Contraction
increases volume and decreases pressure.
If external intercostal muscles are more involved in breathing, then such breathing is called thoracic breathing. Now take phrenic muscle present at base of ribcage, that is part of diaphragm. Again, contraction will move diaphragm downward to anteroposterior
axis,
resulting in increase in volume of ribcage. Now you can see here, so this is ribcage and this is diaphragm. During inhalation, diaphragm moves down. So diaphragm gets straight means originally it was here, now get moved down means become straight. So this much of volume get increased, which results in fall in pressure in ribcage. This fall in pressure due to movement of phrenic muscle and due to movement of external intercostal muscle will help to
pull air inside.
Finally, we can say contraction of external intercostal muscle and phrenic muscles results in increase in volume and decrease in pressure by 2 to 6 mm of Hg. You can see here
pressure inside the lungs
get decreased, which results in inflow of air, leads to inspiration. As we have discussed, if during inhalation
ribs work
more prominently, we can call it thoracic breathing. And if diaphragm is mainly involved in breathing, then it is called abdominal breathing. If phrenic muscles are mainly involved in inhalation, then we can call it abdominal breathing. If rib muscles are majorly involved in breathing, then it is called thoracic breathing. At resting condition, abdominal breathing
predominates. During exercise,
thoracic breathing get dominated. One more important statement:
at very resting condition,
we can do breathing without moving ribs. Means at resting stage, we can show abdominal breathing only. Let us now discuss the way of inhalation by a diagram. You can see here the arrows are going in. This is air is moving in. From here, it is reaching to the lungs. And in this diagram, between ribs, at this position, there will be external intercostal muscles. And contraction of these muscles will pull ribcage outward, forward at dorsoventral axis. You can see here, this is the diaphragm, this part. When the muscles of diaphragm will contract, the diaphragm gets straightened, means pulled down at anteroposterior axis. That results in increase in volume, and which finally result in inhalation of air. So, during inhalation, this rib cage will move forward, upward, and diaphragm will move downward and will come at this position. So, finally, both the contraction of phrenic muscles and external intercostal muscles
will result in
increase in volume, decrease in pressure, and finally, inflow of air. Let us now discuss expiration. Expiration means exhalation of air. In previous topic of inspiration,
we studied
two muscles. One was external intercostal muscle and second was phrenic muscles. We studied in inspiration, the contraction of both these muscles pulls ribcage outward, resulting in increase in volume and decrease in pressure that finally results in inspiration, means inflow of air. During expiration, relaxation of both these muscles will bring rib cage back to position, means reduces volume of thoracic cage and increases pressure in thoracic cage. This pressure get increased by the value of 2 to 5 mm of Hg, which finally results in outflow of air. See, now you can see in the diagram, this air is moving out from lungs. It happens when the phrenic muscles of diaphragm relaxes. Diaphragm, which was initially at this position during inhalation, get back to the position. See, you can see diaphragm again get arced or curved, resulting in reduction in volume. And then same way, the external intercostal muscles between the ribs, when get relaxed, rib cage get back to normal position. So relaxation of both external intercostal muscle and phrenic muscle results in exhalation. And these are the muscles which was responsible for inhalation. So contraction of these muscles results in inhalation. Relaxation of these muscles results in exhalation. I am talking about normal exhalation. Let us now discuss forceful exhalation. During forceful exhalation, internal intercostal muscles will come in operation along with abdominal muscles. So contraction of both these muscles will reduce volume of ribcage, which results in forceful exhalation. So finally, we can say external intercostal muscles and phrenic muscles both are involved in inhalation and exhalation. But for forceful exhalation, the muscles involved are internal intercostal muscles and abdominal muscle. So this is the process of expiration or exhalation. So let us now discuss functions of respiration. If we talk about respiration, we can consider it for cellular respiration. So cellular respiration helps in energy production. As we know that cellular respiration means oxidation of glucose, and complete glucose oxidation yields ATP, heat, CO2 and water. ATP production is 45%. Second function of respiration is excretion. At this point, we can consider lungs as additional or accessory excretory organ. Lungs helps to excrete out CO2, water, etc. About 18 liter of CO2 get excreted out per day by lungs, and about 400 ml of water get excreted out per day. Another function of respiration is by eliminating CO2, it helps to maintain acid-base balance of body. Also helps to maintain temperature of body, because a large number of heat is expelled out during expiration, which means maintenance of body temperature. One more function, return of blood and lymph. During inhalation and exhalation, muscles of thorax, means intercostal muscles and abdominal muscles, phrenic muscles, etc. works. Contraction of these muscles results in changes in pressure of abdominal zone, which results in backflow of blood in veins and also lymph in lymphatic vessels. Because we know that blood in arteries moves by the pressure created by heart, while blood in veins moves by the movement of body parts or contraction of muscles. So these are few functions of respiration, including cellular respiration.
Hey there, hope you understood the concept. Here's the solution to the question asked at the beginning. Found this video useful? Hit the like and share buttons to enjoy more such videos. LearnPedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain over 4,000 videos and over 20,000 questions. You can access them online, on our website, and offline through SD card or pen drive solutions. Buy now at www.learnpedia.in. You can also try a free demo of a product before making a purchase.